I'm going to show you in this screencast a simple calculation within a user form. So this is just about one of the most basic user forms that we could actually set up. Before I put together a user form, I oftentimes just draw a schematic of how I want this thing to work before going straight into the editor. So I have this initial user form, and I want the user to be able to enter an A, enter a B, and then when they press calculate, it will actually spit out the product of those two numbers. When the user presses reset, it'll wipe those clean, A and B, and then the user can actually modify those and start over. And then, as always, we want to put a quit button, so when the user presses quit, the user form will disappear. We start out by going into Excel, Alt F11 to bring up the editor. And then I'm going to go over here and insert a user form. And it looks something like this. For this example, we want to have some text. So we'll have a label here. You can change it. And then you can put a text box here for what the user can input there. And you can also add buttons here. Another thing you need to do is you need to name anything that actually gets input from the user. So this is a text box. The default name is text box, but we might make this something more descriptive like A input. So I've gone ahead and formatted everything nicely. I just want to show you exactly what I've got. So here we have, this is named A value, this is named B value, and this is going to be named product. We have a calculate button, I've named that calculate button. We have quit button and reset button. In order to calculate the product, we're going to take the value in A times B value. And when the button calculate is pressed, the product is going to be calculated. We can double click on this button, and this is where we're going to put the code in there to calculate the product. Product is going to be equal to A value times B value. It's as easy as that. So let's go back to the user form. We also want to put in a reset, so that'll wipe everything clean. And there's a statement unload, and then you use your user form name. Unload user form 1 basically removes everything and shuts that user form down. Now we want this to actually pop back up because we're just resetting it. To bring up that user form again, we type in user form 1.show. Now the only other button we have is quit. So let's double click on quit, and we can type in the command user form 1.height, and that will actually quit the user form. So we're almost ready to go. The only problem now, you can't just run a user form. You actually have to run it from a module. So let's go in here. We're going to insert a module, and I'm going to write a sub simple product. I just want to show the user form. So user form 1.show. When we run module 1, it will open up or show that user form, and then the user can do something with it. One last thing, I'm going to transfer back over to Excel. I'm going to go up here to developer and insert button. And I'm going to assign this button to our simple product. I can just make this be go. I'm going to press go. We can enter a 5, for example, a 4. We can click calculate. It calculates the product. We reset. It wipes everything clean and then re-shows the form. So let's see if it works for something different. 20 times 10, we can calculate the product. And then I can reset and I can quit. This is just a very easy way to create a simple user form that uses some sort of calculations in VBA.